What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Nation Fusion, and today we have a early access preview of World's Drift. So this is the character that I've made. Quite a cool game. I'm enjoying it so far. It's got a lot of interesting concepts and a lot of interesting features. It is a little slow. That's the first thing I'll say. It takes a while to get things rolling, but once you do, it's pretty easy to get the hang of, and it's a lot of fun. So what is Worlds of Drift? I don't know. Let's hop in and tell you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Worlds of Drift. And this is a game in which you build massive or small airships and fuel them, bound them to gravity, and fly them. This is a ship that I put together over the last couple of days. It does take some time to get things like rolling, as I said before, and this game is very unoptimized at the moment, so you're going to see a lot of like lag and probably jump cuts in this video, based on where I've got to edit out some of the lag. But so this is what you do. You build a ship like this, and you explore these worlds that are adrift. We're going to hop in here. This is our ship. Alright, so I went ahead and put us at a 60-40 split. And as I said, while you're flying, you can still walk around. You have a couple of tools available to you. You have the number one slot is a resource gatherer. This allows you to like gather fuel and wood, that kind of thing. The second one is a repair thing. If your ship is damaged, you can repair it like that. The third is a lifter. You use this inside of like ship bays to like lift up objects. You can customize the ship with different parts and things like that. And then the fourth is our knowledge scanner. You can click this on different things and gain knowledge from whatever you click it on if you haven't already learned that knowledge. So you have a couple of different tools there. And then the big thing on my right hand is my grappling hook, so I can put my grappling hook attached to different objects, and then like you can hang off the side of your pin, you can reel out, you can play the Pirates of the Caribbean theme song while you do this and have a great old time. It's actually pretty fun. However, I'm fat and it's fucking with my ship. Okay, all right, let's get back on the ship now. So now my ship can level out here. My fat ass is off the back of it. We're going to go to that island. It's going to take a long time because, as I said, it takes a long time to do anything in this game. So we're going to take a cut here and we'll be back. Alright, well, quick update. We ran out of fuel in this current form, at least that I've found. There's no way to see exactly how much fuel I have. So the cool thing is in this barrel I used to have fuel. However, I took it out of here, put it in my inventory, and then I died. So I don't have any more fuel. So what we're gonna have to do, we're gonna sail the old-fashioned way, physically fucking longer than flying with engines. So we'll activate our sail. And luckily, we do have the wind with us, so we will sail with the wind over there. So, again, we'll be back when some content happens. Okay, so I was just standing on my ship, and then all of a sudden, I randomly got ejected off. So, we're going to pull this stuff into our belt so we don't lose it. And when we die, we should be able to respawn on the ship. It's not complete yet, so little things like this happen. I have no idea how it happened. I was just standing there, and then all of a sudden, I was ejected from the ship. So let's revive. Oh, look, here we are. Always good, I guess, to anchor yourself to the ship. I almost caught it, but during me, like, falling, I lagged, so I wasn't able to. So what we can do is just like do this, and then we'll just chill here on the ship. And even if I get flung off, I should still be stuck here via my little grappling hook. Okay, so we made it to one of the islands. I'm gonna leave my ship here, not really because I want to, but because we're out of fuel. It appears something is down there that hasn't loaded. What? Once we grab some fuel from this island, which I'm assuming it'll have some, we're gonna go through that wind wall over there, and hopefully we won't die. But we're gonna give it a try. All right, so we're all set. We shouldn't be moving. However, we are. Let's go over here to the side. You gotta be very careful cutting down trees in this game because they literally can kill you. If they fall on you or roll on top of you in the wrong way, you'll lose all of your health. And then sometimes that happens. Alright, these things right here are kind of like large pools of knowledge. So you scan it and make the cool little noise and you see I've gained 35 knowledge as opposed to these little things like what gave me like 4 knowledge, I think. That one gave me 3. Alright guys, we got some wood, we got some fuel, we got a little bit of metal, we got some berries, and we're heading back to the ship now. We're going to fuel our ship up, and then we're going through that wind wall over there towards whatever that thing is. I want to... Guys, one final check-in before we hit this wind wall or storm wall. I don't know exactly how this is going to go. Last time I brought a ship into one of these, it literally disintegrated. And I spent a lot of time on this ship, so I'm a little nervous. It's probably going to be about 5 minutes or so before we hit that wind wall or storm wall. So I just want, like I said, want to check in one more time before we do. I will record once I do hit it, but it's going to take, like I said, a little bit. And then we're going to that little island over there. So, see you guys in about 5 minutes. Alright guys, so after quite a bit of trying to get through this wind wall, I couldn't do it. I'm thinking we don't have enough power. We only have these two engines. So I'm going to add in some more engines probably up here. And then we got to fix our sail because it broke trying to get through there. And then I might redo the wings as well. I don't know. We're going to head back to one of these islands, create a shipyard, and we'll probably end the episode of this preview there. While I'm flying, because this is going to take some time, I got to say, I do like the game. I do feel like there's a lot of barriers right now because of how early access it is. There's not a lot of like good descriptive things on like how much power do I need to get through that wind wall. You know, is there certain colors of wind walls that certain amounts of engines can go through? Because if you look here in my schematics, it says the ones I have on there is this one right here, the scrap heap steamer E10s. It says provides the propulsion required to travel wind walls and storm walls, but it didn't let me through. So obviously I don't have enough of it. So I'm going to go back. I'm going to build this one here, this box pile, smoky. I'm going to build a couple of these, and then I'm going to see if I can get back through the wall later. But it doesn't tell me anywhere in here like what I need to get through what. So that's my my theory on it. We're heading towards one of these little islands here, and then like I said, I'll collect some resources, see if I can upgrade this ship a little bit. The reason why there's no paneling, I know some of you are going to be like, well, why does your ship don't have any paneling, that kind of stuff. It's too heavy. I created a custom design here. It's a little bigger than the normal one of these, so it's having a tough time as far as like weight-wise getting up here in the air. and I only have this basic fusion core, Atlas core, whatever it's called, that provides the lift for the ship. So until I can find an upgraded one of those motherfuckers, we're pretty much stuck with what we got. So we're heading to this island, and we're going to see if we can do some upgrading. Alright guys, so I've decided to go to this island. This is where we're going to log off for the day. But I saw this massive ship over here. That looks really cool. I wonder, usually ships log out if you log out. So that must mean this guy's still here. I'm hoping he doesn't decide to kill me. Oh god damn it. It's this guy again. Come, what the heck? There's two of you! Oh, there's three of you! Please. Leave. This ship is not yours. Oh my god! Guys, there's too many. That's one. They're trying to eat my ship. They're eating it. I'm gonna die. Let me just... I'm out of bullets! Oh, no, please! We gotta make more bullets. On the fly. This is not good. I can't tell if this one's still alive or not. First, we need to stop the... We need to stop the ship. God damn it. Combat needs a little bit of work. Great. I think when we died, we dropped a bag. But apparently the bag is not here. So, what shall we do? Let's see if I have any metal in here. Alright, so we're going to anchor ourselves. Build some more bullets. Frames are down to like 12. This guy's trying to use my personal reviver. I don't know which ones are alive and which ones are dead anymore. Assuming that one's dead now. Let's see if we can like get it up. Can. This one's dead too? Yes, okay. This one's dead. Eating my power core, like those little things from Star Wars. Alright, that one's dead. We're passing the island. Okay, well, that was an eventful ending to the video. Thank you. Alright, so this is the island where we want to be. Alright, so we made it onto this island. This is where we will leave off. Next time when we come back and explore more Worlds Adrift, we will upgrade our ship. We'll put some, hopefully, siding on the sides of it and make it an actual air-faring ship. We're probably going to try and add another engine on there. But before we do that, we're going to have to try and upgrade our Atlas core or our Atlas engine, whatever it's called. Until we do that, we will be here, gathering and exploring and learning more about Worlds Adrift. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're interested in checking out Worlds Adrift, please go ahead and check out their Steam page. You can actually create islands for this game for free and upload them to the community, which will then be implemented in the game if they're approved. We'll have a video on that next time. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think of Worlds Adrift. Do you plan on getting it? Are you waiting? Are you passing? What are your opinions on what you've seen here today? Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I look forward to hearing from you in the comments. Until next time, this is Daily from Nation Fusion, and you're watching Nation Fusion TV.